Hello everyone, welcome back to e-classes of Commerce Standard 12. In this video, we are going to continue our next topic, that is difference between gross working capital and net working capital. In our last video, we had an idea about the concept of working capital in which we studied about gross working capital and net working capital. But in this video, we'll have a quick revision by studying its difference between. So let's start with the first point, that is meaning. Let's read it. Gross working capital means sum total of current assets such as bills receivable, debtors, short-term marketable securities, bank balance, cash, etc. Whereas net working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. So this we have studied that gross working capital means the total current assets of the company. And which are our current assets? Our current assets are bills, receivables, debtors, short-term marketable securities, cash, bank balance. These are our current assets. So, we can say that gross working capital is equals to total current assets. Whereas, net working capital means current assets minus current liabilities. That means excess of current assets over current liabilities. Second point, liquidity position. This concept does not indicate the liquidity position of the company. Whereas in net working capital, this concept indicates liquidity position of the company. So, in gross working capital, liquidity position is not known. Now, liquidity position means it cannot be estimated the cash on hand or bank balance with the help of gross working capital. But with the help of net working capital, company can know its liquidity position. That means cash on hand, bank balance, all can be known with the help of net working capital. Third point, financial position and measurement. Let's read it. It does not have a true idea of the financial position of the company. Whereas in net working capital, it gives the true idea of financial position of the company. So, gross working capital cannot give the true idea about the financial position of the company, as gross working capital is equal to total current assets. Gross working capital can only give the idea about the current assets of the business or company, whereas net working capital can give idea about the financial position of the company, that whether the company is financially sound or not. Fourth point, increase in current liabilities. Increase in current liabilities increase the gross working capital, whereas in net working capital, increase in current liability does not increase in net working capital. That means if current liabilities of any company increases, that means it is increase in the gross working capital too. But in net working capital, if there is increase in current liabilities, it does not increase in net working capital. So here we have done the four different point of gross working capital and net working capital. Go through the topic, revise it thoroughly. Thank you.